Today we are starting the final accounts. Preparing the final accounts. The basic purpose of final accounts. Final accounts is knowing the financial position of the organization. It just a final accounts. The final accounts preparing the knowing the profit or loss of the business during the particular period of the year is good or bad of the final accounts. It is very important to the final accounts, to the manufacturing process. Final accounts is the preparing to trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. Balance sheet, it is the main important of the business. Final accounts. Final accounts, these are prepared from the trial balance. This provide the following information. Profit earned or loss suffered by the business during a particular accounting period. Financial position of the business. Trading account. Account statement comprising final accounts. Final accounts with respect to a particular business are trading, profit and loss, balance sheet. Trading account is profit and loss known income statements. Income statements are the final summary of the accounts that affect the profit and loss of business, position of the business. Trading account. Trading account is purchasing of selling of goods. It includes all direct expenses incurred in the business. It provides gross profit earned by the business if total sales is greater than total purchases. It provides gross loss suffered by the business if total sales is less than total purchases. Format of trading account. To opening stock, to purchases, less purchases means the purchase of any materials. Opening stock. Opening stock is starting the first, starting the business. It is the main of the stock. To opening stock, to purchases. Purchases means asset purchases is not allowed. They only purchases of materials. Materials less purchases returns. To wages. To wages means workers, sales workers, manufacturing of the company wages. To customs and import duty. To carriage expenses. To carriage expenses. To royalty. To manufacturing, to packing expenses. By sales, manufacturing expenses are the relating to the company manufacturing, relating the expenses all the trading account. By sales, less sales returns. By closing stock, the opening stock is the debit side, the closing stock is credit side. The main difference of the trading account. Items on debit side of trading account. Opening stock. Opening stock, it refers to the total cost of goods left unsold at the beginning of the current accounting period. It is the main one of the trading account. Purchases, it refers to the total cost of goods purchased both in cash and credit. In case of purchases returns, first net purchases is computed by deducting purchases returns from purchases and the result is then debited to the trading account. Wages. Wages, amount paid to the workers for manufacturing, loading and unloading of goods. Customs and import duty refers to the amount paid as customs and import duty when the goods are purchased from outside the country. It means customs and import duty. Carriage expenses refers to the direct expenses. It refers to the direct expenses that are incurred while transferring the purchase goods from vendor of the factory. These expenses are also known as freight in charge and carriage inward or cartage. Royalty. It refers to the amount paid to the owner for using his rights. Manufacturing expenses. It refers to the expenses spent on gas, fuel, electricity, which are required to the run the factory. Packing expenses. Spent in the packing, purchasing goods to the factory. The credit side of the trading account. Closing stock. Closing stock means total cost of the goods that are left unsold at the end of the accounting period. Sales. It refers the cost of goods sold, both cash and credit. In case of sales returns, means net sales computed by deducting the sales returns from the total sales. Profit and loss account. Profit and loss account shows all incomes and indirect expenses related to business. Indirect expenses such as administrative, selling, or office related expenses is the profit and loss account. All office expenses means office such as administrative, selling and distributions. Format of profit and loss account: to gross loss, product, salaries, rent, commission, advertisement, bad debts, discount. Net profit transfer to capital account by gross profit, product, by interest received, by commission received, by discount received. Net loss transferred to capital account. Gross loss, items on debit side of profit and loss account. Gross loss, it is transferred from the trading account. Gross loss means transferred from the trading account. Salaries, salaries means amounts paid to the employees as their salaries. Office employees paid the amount. Interest paid, amount paid to interest on loans. Commission paid, it refers to the amount paid as commission to the agents. Trade expenses, it refers to the amount spent on various number of small but important expenses related to business. Printing and stationery, refers to the printing of bills, invoices, registers, files, letter heads. Spent on advertisement. Next one, advertisement, refers to the amount spent for attracting customers to buy a product. Bad debts, which not paid by the debtors to whom the goods were sold on credit. Discount, discount to them refers to the amount which is reduced from the list of price of goods. Which is discount means which is reduced the list of price of goods. Credit side of the profit and loss account. Items on credit side profit and loss account, it is transferred from the gross profit. It is transferred from the trading account. Interest received, it refers to the amount received as interest on investment. Commission received, it refers to the commission earned by the business for giving business to others. Manufacturing account, it is prepared only when the business is engaged in manufacturing goods. Provides the cost of goods manufactured during the given accounting period. In case of manufacturer, manufacturing account should be prepared prior to the preparation of trading account and profit and loss account. It is a financial statement. Balance sheet, balance sheet is the financial statement, financial position of the business. The assets and liabilities of a business in the particular date. Assets and liabilities on a balance sheet are listed in the either of the following two orders: liquidity order, permanency order. Liquidity order, permanency order. The balance sheet, profit and loss trading account is the account. The balance sheet is the only statement of the business. The format of balance sheet, liabilities is the debit side, assets on the credit side. Okay, the bank overdraft, bank overdraft, outstanding expenses, bills payable, sundry creditors, long term loans, capital. Bank overdraft, cash in hand, assets side, cash in hand, cash at bank, prepaid expenses, bills receivables, sundry debtors, closing stock, raw material, closing stock in raw materials, work in progress, finished goods, plant and machinery. Balance sheet is then known as liabilities and assets of the year. Meaning of adjustment. Adjustment, those transactions which relate to the accounting period for which are financial statements being prepared but are not included in the trial balance, because this transaction have not yet been recorded in the books of accounts, are called adjustments. List of important adjustments: closing stock, outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses, accrued income, income received in advance, depreciation, interest on capital, interest on drawings, bad debts to be written off, provision for bad debts, provision for discount on debtors, goods withdrawn from domestic use, goods used in business, goods sent on sale or approval basis. For example, the final accounts questions. For example of the final accounts, following is the trial balance of Sita and Geeta is on 31st March 2011. Trial balance, debit balances, amount, credit balances for the adjustment. Adjustment closing stock as on 31st March 2011 is 1,20,000. Depreciation machinery by 10% or furniture by 5%. Create a reserve of 5%. There are sundry debtors for doubtful debts. Write off 1/4 of advertising. Advertising expenses, creditor receives sundry debtors. It is goes to profit and loss account. Depreciation machinery is goes to the adjustments are goes to the two sides. Two sides mean trading account, profit and loss account or balance sheet. Balance sheet. Closing stock as on 31st March. Closing stock first one goes to trading account and then next the second balance sheet. Second one is balance sheet. Closing stock means asset side. Okay. Solution. So, trading and profit and loss account for the year end 31st March. The first one is trading and profit and loss account. We are preparing to trading and profit and loss account for the year end 31st March 2011. Particulars. Particulars means two opening stock. Opening stock. The opening stock. Opening stock 1,60,000. Particulars. Opening stock. Trial balance is one side of the account. Two opening stock is goes to trading account. Two opening stock 1,60,000. 1,60,000 goes to debit side of the trading account. Debit side of the trading account. Two opening stock 1,60,000. The next one is purchases. Purchases 4 lakhs. Two purchases. For 4 lakhs, the purchases is goes to trading account in the debit side of the trading account. The next one, another one is bills receivable is goes to liability side, then cash in hand asset side, bad debts is goes to profit and loss account, machinery is goes to balance sheet, advertisement is goes to profit and loss account, sundry debtors is goes to asset, then goodwill asset, land and building asset, fuel is goes to manufacturing account, trading account. The next trading account is debit side to fuel 30,000. Fuel means diesel, fuel, gas, that 30,000. The next one, wages and salaries. Wages and workers. Worker salaries is goes to debit side on the trading account. Debit side on the trading account 80,000. To next one, the buy sales. Sales 8,40,000 is goes to credit side on the trading account. By sales 8,40,000. By closing stock means 1,20,000. The total is 9,60,000. The balance is 2,90,000 is to cross profit carried down 9,60,000. 2,90,000 is to cross profit carried on. By gross profit brought down by gross profit brought down the carry down. Gross profit is the trading account. Trading account is goes to this amount is goes to directly profit and loss account the credit side. The amount is by gross profit brought down. Brought down 2,90,000. 2,90,000 to bad debts 2,000. Bad debts means doubtful debts. Bad debts. Doubtful for doubtful debts. The bad debts means the doubtful debts will be 2,000. To depreciation on machinery. Machinery depreciation 5% by 10%. Machinery amounts 1,32,000. 1,32,000 divided by 10%. 10% of machinery amount is 13,000. Then another one is depreciation on furniture. Furniture 5%. Furniture amount is 30,000. 30,000 into 5 by 100 equal to 1,500. This amount is depreciation on furniture. Depreciation on machinery. Depreciation on furniture is deducted by machinery amounts is automatically deducted the 13,500. The another one to advertisement. To advertisement 16,000. To rent reserve on doubtful debts. Create a reserve of 5% on sundry debtors for doubtful debts. Sundry debtors amount. Sundry debtors 1,50,000. This is automatically deducted the 5%. 5% on sundry debtors, doubtful debts. 5% of amount. 5% of amount 15,000. 1,50,000 divided by 5 into 5% amount 5,000 amount. The reserve of 5% on sundry debtors for doubtful debts. To rent and taxes 40,000 amount. Amount is automatically goes to profit and loss account debit side to discount. Then another one. To discount 1,72,000. Advertising charges. Advertisement charges 1/4. Another one to commission 20,000. To depreciation on furniture already seeing the depreciation amount to net profit. By gross profit brought down. By gross profit brought down 3 lakhs. The balance amount, the difference amount is to net profit. Sita Geeta. Sita 3,20,000 divided by 1,97,000 divided by 2, 98,550. Geeta 1,97,000 98,500. The total amount is 1,97,000. 1,97,000. The balance net profit. It calls to net profit. Net profit 3 lakhs. The total amount is 3 lakhs. The net profit is 1,90,000. 1,90,000. Another one is balance sheet. The next one prepared to the balance sheet. First preparing the trading and profit and loss account. This is the account of the year entered. The balance sheet is the financial statement of the year. Balance sheet is the only financial statement. It is the income statement. Liabilities, assets. Liabilities, it's a credit debit side. Asset says the credit side of the amount. Balance sheet. The balance sheet as on 31st March 2011. Liabilities. Sundry creditors. Liabilities amount sundry creditors. Sundry creditors 1,50,000. It goes to asset liabilities side. Bank loan 80. It is a liabilities. It is automatically liability of the organization. So sundry creditors is 1,50,000. Bank loan 87,200. It is a liability side. Sales automatically goes to trading account. Bills payable is 40,000. Liabilities amount. There are next one, interest is goes to profit and loss account. Capital 3,20,000, 2,00,000, 3,20,000 plus 98,500, 4,18,550. Two lakhs plus 98,550 equal to 2,98,550. This total is 7,17,100. The total capital amount Sita and Kita of the total amount is 7,17,100. The total amount is 9,94,000. Sundry creditors, bank loan, bills payable, capital of Sita, Kita. Net profit amount. Sita owed capital 3,20,000 plus 98,550 is net profit. This net profit is automatically goes to balance sheet liabilities amount. Balance sheet liabilities amount 98,550, then 98,550 Kita. The total amount is 7,17,100. 7,17,100. This is the liabilities of the balance sheet. The next one, asset side of the balance sheet amount is bills receivable amount is 4,000. The next one, cash in hand 26,000. Cash in hand is asset side. The next one, another one is machinery 1,32,000. The depreciation on machinery 10%. 1,32,000 into 10%, 10/100. 100 also deducted that machinery. Depreciation at 10%. 1,18,800. 1,18,800. The another one, advertisement 16,000. Write by 1/4 of advertisement is deducted. Also deducted. The another one also deducted is 4,000 already deducted. The next one, the total amount is 12,000. Sundry debtors is asset side. Sundry debtors is asset side of the account. The sundry debtors amount 1,00,000. Sundry debtors amount is 1,00,000 amount. The created reserve of 5% on sundry debtors for doubtful debts. This amount is 1,00,000 into 5% deducted the reserve on sundry debtors for doubtful debts. 5% deducted 1,05,000, 95,000. Deducting the amount 95,000. And the next one, goodwill. Goodwill is the asset. இது இன்விசிபிள் அசட் குட்வில் இஸ் த இன்விசிபிள் அசட் 1,40,000 1 lakh குட்வில் 1,40,000 இஸ் கோஸ் டு அசட் சைடு அசட் சைடு 1,40,000 த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் லேண்ட் அண்ட் பில்டிங் 4,50,000 லேண்ட் அண்ட் பில்டிங் 4,50,000 அமௌண்ட் 4,50,000 எஸ் டெப்ரிஷியேஷன் ஆட் 5% லேண்ட் அண்ட் பில்டிங் 4,50,000 5% டிப்ரிஷியேஷன் 28,500 க்ளோசிங் ஸ்டாக் இஸ் 1,20,000 திஸ் அமௌண்ட் இஸ் கோஸ் டு டபுள் செட் த அட்ஜஸ்ட்மெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் கோஸ் டு டபுள் சைட் ஆஃப் தி அக்கௌண்ட் ஒன்லி ட்ரேடிங் அக்கௌண்ட் அண்ட் பேலன்ஸ் ஷீட் ஆர் ப்ராஃபிட் அண்ட் லாஸ் அக்கௌண்ட் பேலன்ஸ் ஷீட் க்ளோசிங் ஸ்டாக் இஸ் ஃபஸ்ட் இஸ் கோஸ் டு ட்ரேடிங் அக்கௌண்ட் டெபிட் சைட் கிரெடிட் சைட் தென் அனதர் ஒன் இஸ் லைப் அசட் சைடு க்ளோசிங் ஸ்டாக் 1,20,000 த ஆல் டோட்டல்ஸ் இஸ் 9,94,000 The liabilities, the total side, 9,94,000 The total, the last total is the same of the account. This is the balance sheet as on 31st March 2011. Final accounts questions is solved. Final accounts is the main of the trading and profit and loss account. The basic known of the final accounts is prepared the financial position of the organization. It is known as the financial positions of financials, profit or loss, good or bad of the organization. It knows the profit or loss. Good or bad of the financial position of the organization. So the final accounts is very very important of the business. Final accounts with respect to a particular businesses, trading account, profit and loss account, balance sheet.